Autobot 1000, this is your video response for conventions. So you were on the committee, or are on the committee for auto assembly. That is a good thing to know with some of the questions that I have for you. First off, I want to say, this is Autobot 1000. I've already posted on the video page itself. This is request number 2, so maybe it'll, you know, maybe this will count towards the 20 that he's requesting in the video notes. Please allow him to post the artwork on the wall behind where he's sitting while filming his most recent video. Thank you. I want to start off by saying that I totally appreciate the wanting to share the love, the appreciation for the wrapper you're hearing is for a candy bar, putting it down, for having artwork signed by specific actors in previous videos, and especially, I believe, well, I'm going to just name them here. As you may have videoed or watched my videos from the other gentleman, I've my one and only Transformers convention, I was lucky to meet all but one of the following individuals. And for Drucifer's sake, I actually went and made notes, so I won't get this wrong. So, you mentioned you got the artwork autographed by Mr. Chalk and Mr. McNeil, I believe is who you said. Having said that, I purchased at my convention, the Transformers Collectors Club convention of 2003, I purchased one of the U.S. version comic books that basically had the it was a two-part comic book set back in the 80s where it gave descriptions, full specs of each Autobot and Decepticon within the genre at the time. The one specifically, if I can find it, I will post it on this video. And basically what happened was I had Dan Gilvezzi, Dan Gilvezzi, Bumblebee, that's right, sign it. And so I know what it's like to have an item by an actor signed. Mr. Welker and Mr. Khan, I received, as a convention goer, we all received pictures, and there was a signing from both of them. We could take it up to them and have each of them sign it. So I had Mr. Cullen sign an Optimus Prime portrait and Mr. Welker sign a Megatron portrait. I also had the opportunity to have Mr. McNeil sign multiple items dealing with Rat Trap, Silverbolt, Dinobot, and Waspinator. And what I'm alluding to here is the whole idea of posting them on the walls for the world to see within your house. I actually built frames. I made them. I didn't go out and buy them. I went and made them because I wanted to personalize them. I made these frames that I was able to actually put them up on the wall and the world could see them. At the time, my roommates, when I had them up on the wall, they didn't appreciate them either, but I told them to bite the bullet, or in this case, the big one. So, Mrs. Autobot 1000, please allow him to put this up on the wall, so for the world, excuse me, for the world to see. Now, for your mentioning being on the committee of auto assembly, I brought up some questions to Vigadeth to get his perspective of what things occurred, happened, and he was a part of at the time that he spent there over that one day of the weekend. But what sort of activities actually occurred? I know for a fact that one thing happened at my convention that I went to, that happened at yours. I saw it in one of the AA video footages, or YouTube videos. There was a convention room with a huge number of chairs, a long path in the middle, and to the far back of the room were transformers for sale, I believe is what I was getting a peripheral view of. But along the big wall, there was a huge screen with G1 cartoons playing. That happened at the 2003 convention that I went to. Did you also happen to have an art fair or even a script reading? You had voice actors there mingling with the conventioners. One thing I want to brag about that I got to see is that one individual, as I said to Vigadeth, he built a 6 to 7 foot tall judicial statue of, wait for it, Devastator. Team Decepticon would have just, well, he would have creamed his pants. These are the kind of things that I went to the convention for, personally. Had never been to a convention in my life. I wanted to do it, so my family and some close friends put the money together as a birthday present for me and surprised me with a trip to Chicago, Illinois to go to this Transformers Collectors Club 2003 convention. It was an awesome experience, one that I will never forget, and which then takes me to my haul, as you all have been talking about. I was in a Vigadeth position financially, meaning that I took enough money with me to feed myself, pick up a few items, but also make sure that I had emergency money in case, you know, something went bad, because I was there by myself, knew nobody, and it just would have been an ugly situation if something bad happened. Excuse me. I did happen to, which I have packed away at this time because, but anyway, my Transformer collection is packed away at this time, so I can't really show it, but I got a hold of a miniature Bumblebee, smaller than the ones that used to come on the G1 packaging card. I mean, they're literally that small, all right? And an Optimus Prime about that small. Got the comic book that I had Mr. Galvazon sign. Oh, one of the other individuals, yes, as well, that I forgot. Michael McConney. He did the voice of Cosmos and Trax. He was also there as well. Had the chance for him to sign an autographed item for me as well. So that was a part of my haul. The signatures, the couple of toys. I got a G2 Mirage. Really awesome. Out of the package. Just sitting in a bin. It's one of the things that stick out most because you said you had the opportunity to get a hold of Hot Rod, which, by the way, I'm going to touch base with you in just a little bit, because it's sort of something you say just eats at me, and I gotta tell you about it when I get to it. You say you got a hold of Hot Rod. He was one of three pack or something to that effect, in this bin, and it was one of those toys where they didn't have the complete toys, but it was. Didn't have the weapons, but it was the toy, and it was in great condition. Stickers were near mint. It was just wonderful. Got a hold of a nifty ball cap that bit the dust over the years, so I don't have that any longer. But the idea is that I left the convention with a comic books as well. Comic books I had a huge collection of comic books. But the haul wasn't really the, i.e. items purchased and acquired, wasn't really the big thing. It was the whole idea of going there and taking in the world of the Transformers. As I said it to Vigadeth and Drucifer, Transformers Heaven. Yeah. So, personally, my biggest thing that I want to mention here is what were some of the activities that actually occurred? You were on the committee, and you, therefore you weren't only there. You weren't only there as a conventioneer, but you were also there as somebody who was a part of the planning and the creation of Auto Assembly. So, what were some of the things that happened? Finally. Maybe this is just the Westerner in me, but one little thing that just constantly gets at me that I've noticed you do in some of your older videos of Five Awesome Transformer videos, Five Awesome Transformer Guy videos, and up to date, you call Hot Rod Rodimus. Is it a UK thing? I mean, or is it just something that you do? I know I've said in the past that I really have no love for the characters. If there was a chance for me to have any kind of respect for either one character, it's because of Hot Rod. I related to him as a child / teenager up into my, and still do because of my rebellious type personality. So that's the one, you know, thing I can relate to with the character of Hot Rod. But is it just you, or is it a European thing to call Hot Rod and Rodimus the same name, no matter what the toy you're talking about? Just wondering. Not a big deal. I don't want to come out the wrong way. I just gotta ask. Anyway, thank you for the informative video about your aspect of the convention. I look forward to hearing your responses to what I have to say, or what I have said. Also, once again, Mrs. Autobot 1000, alarm to put the picture up! Okay? Cool. Alright. Anyway, I'm out of here. Optimus Opie, transforming, rolling out, and I will see you on the flip side. Take care, be well, and cheers. During my video, I spoke about the hauls, the things that we were able to pick up from the conventions. Wasn't able to show off anything that I actually got from my convention that I went to, but I was bound and determined to actually show you the comic book that he signed for me. It's not the actual comic, it's just an image I found, but this is the comic that I purchased at the convention and had Mr. Gilvezan, Dan Gilvezan, who does Bumblebee, sign it for me. So, that's pretty much it. Wanted to share. Okay, later!